Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video we are going to learn about Marmars. Okay, about the Marmars. Marmars occur due to turbulence in the blood flow at or near a valve. Marmars occur due to turbulence in the blood flow at or near a valve or an abnormal communication within the heart. Okay. Murmur occur due to turbulence in the blood flow at or near a valve or an abnormal communication within the heart. Murmurs differ from heart sounds in the sense that these are of longer duration and higher frequency. Okay. Murmurs differ from heart sounds in the sense that these murmurs are longer duration and higher frequency. These differ from heart sounds, okay, in the sense that these are of longer duration and higher frequency. Whereas heart sounds have shorter duration and lower frequency. Murmurs, longer duration, higher frequency. Heart sounds, shorter duration, lower frequency. When a murmur is present, the following points are carefully noted. Okay. First, site of origin of murmur. The area over which murmur is maximally heard is noted. The area over which murmur is maximally heard is noted. The point of maximal intensity usually indicates its site of origin. The point of maximal intensity usually indicates its site of origin. It is not always, okay, in more times. And timing and duration. Depending on the timing of murmur, murmurs are classified into systolic, diastolic. Depending on timing, these murmurs are classified into systolic, diastolic or continuous. Okay, it may be systolic or diastolic or continuous. Depending on the duration, it may be early diastolic, mid diastolic, early systolic, pan systolic. Okay, depending on the duration. See here. Depending on duration, it may be early diastolic, mid diastolic, early systolic, pan systolic. Okay, next coming to the character. The murmur may be soft blowing to harsh, rough, rumbling. Okay, the murmur may be soft blowing to harsh, rough and rumbling. Okay. Loud and rough murmurs are usually associated with organic valvular and congenital lesion. Loud and rough murmurs are usually associated with organic valvular and congenital lesions. Okay. Next, radiation or conduction. From the site of maximum intensity, auscultation is performed in different directions to detect where the murmur is localized or conducted to other parts. The conduction is characteristic of some murmurs. Example, murmur of mitral stenosis is usually localized whereas murmur of mitral incompetence is selectively propagates towards the axilla. Whereas the murmur of mitral incompetence selectively propagates towards the axilla. Next, relation with respiration. During inspiration, the stroke volume of right ventricle increases. During inspiration, stroke volume of right ventricle increases while that of left ventricle decreases. During inspiration, stroke volume of right ventricle increases while that of left ventricle decreases. Therefore, any murmur become louder during inspiration is considered to originate from the right ventricle. Therefore, any murmur becoming louder during inspiration is considered to originate from the right ventricle, and any murmur increasing during expiration is contributed to origin from the left side of the heart. Inspiration, right ventricle murmur, and during expiration, it may be originate from left side of the heart. Okay, this is about the murmur. Okay guys, if you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.